Hey guys, today's video is gonna be really quick. I'm going to be comparing the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask with the new Tatcha Kisu Lip Mask. I know it's not new, they did have it out before, but I believe it's reformulated and it's now permanent. I'm just gonna, spoiler alert, I don't like the Tatcha one. I really don't. I feel like it does more harm than good, and I'm gonna tell you why. So the Tatcha mask is 36 Canadian or 28 US dollars. You get 9 grams or 0.32 ounces of product. With the Laneige, it's 26 Canadian or 20 US dollars, and you get 20 grams or 0.7 ounces of product. So the Laneige already, it's cheaper and you get more than double the amount of product that you get with the Tatcha. They both come with a little wand. I really don't use them, to be honest. I just use my nail or my finger. The Tatcha packaging I think is a little bit cuter, but really it doesn't matter. As for the physical appearance of the formula, the Tatcha is, it looks like a gel kind of. It's more clear and the Laneige is creamier and there's more color to it. Once you put it on your hand, it doesn't just instantly go away. You can kind of see the color. It's more dense looking than the Tatcha. The Tatcha is a bit lighter and more gel-like. The Tatcha one is unscented and there's no taste to it, which I know some people would really like. They can be sensitive to smells, whereas the Laneige, there's all different types of flavors, and I don't know if they have an unscented one, to be honest. I think they're all like, I have the grapefruit one, I really like that. And I don't think there's an option for just nothing. When I apply both of these, the Tatcha one is a bit stickier and it feels like it just sits on top of my skin, whereas the Laneige is more creamy and it actually feels like it soaks in and my skin absorbs it. Honestly, this Tatcha one is really not good. I don't find it very efficient. I find it can feel soothing immediately once you put it on your skin, but the results are not there. It doesn't do any lasting like repair to your lips. Whereas for the Laneige, I can sleep with that for like one night and my lips feel amazing the entire next day. The Tatcha one does not give me that. I don't like it. It just sits on top of my skin and I feel like it makes my lips worse. Like once it comes off, my lips feel like they instantly need something else on top of them to help them feel better. Where the Laneige, my lips feel hydrated afterwards, even with no product on. It's like, the Laneige is a lifesaver. The Tatcha one, it really doesn't do anything for me. Basically, save your money on this one. Go buy the Laneige, 100%. I haven't found any that actually beats the Laneige lip mask yet. This one, yeah, sure, it's a lot of money. I know the product will last a long time, but it's not effective, so there's really no point to using it if it's not going to do what it says. Go with the Laneige, it's cheaper and you get more than double the amount of product, and it actually is effective in repairing like dry parched lips. It's really good. Quick recap, the Tatcha, sticky formula, a little bit uncomfortable, doesn't sink into your skin, just sits on top, doesn't go anywhere, and doesn't actually help your lips at all. They feel almost worse when the product comes off because they still need something else to help them. The Laneige one, on the other hand, is a nice creamy formula, sinks into your skin, helps your lips feel like replenished once you're done with it. They feel repaired, they feel moisturized, they feel just everything you need in a lip mask is in the Laneige. That's all I have for today's video. Thanks so much for watching and I'll see you later. Bye.